Hello, you are watching Radiology Buzz, and we welcome all of you to Radiology Buzz family. Let's study smart with us for your bright future. Today's topic: basic principles of MRI scan. How do protons help in MR imaging? Basic 4 steps of MR imaging: longitudinally magnetization, transverse magnetization, MR signal, resonance in MRI. Basic principles of MRI scan. Magnetic resonance imaging is a medical imaging technique used in radiology to for pictures of the anatomy and the physiological processes of the body. MRI scanners use strong magnetic field gradients, and radio waves to generate images of the organs in the body. Present MR imaging is based on proton imaging. Proton is a positively charged particle in the nucleus of every atom. The isotope of hydrogen nucleus called protium. Protium is the MR active nucleus used in clinical MR imaging. It is used because hydrogen very abundant in the human body and because its solitary proton give it a relatively large magnetic moment. How do protons help in MR imaging? The hydrogen nucleus contains one positively charged proton that spins, that is, it rotates. Any moving charge generate current. Every current has a small magnetic field around it. So, every spinning proton has a small magnetic field around it, also called magnetic dipole moment. Normally, the proton in human body moves randomly in any direction. When patient is placed in the magnetic board, these randomly moving protons align and spin in the direction of external magnetic field. Some of them align parallel and other anti-parallel to the external magnetic field. Where the protons are aligned along external magnetic field, not only it rotates around itself, called spin, but also its axis of rotation moves, forming a cone. This moment of axis of rotation of a proton is called as a precession. The number of precessions of a proton per second is called precession frequency. It is measured in hertz. Precession frequency is directly proportional to strength of external magnetic field. Stronger the external magnetic field, higher is the precession frequency. This relationship is expressed by Larmor's equation. W naught is equal to gamma naught, where W naught is equal to precession frequency in hertz. B naught is equal to strength of external magnetic field in Tesla. Gamma is equal to gyromagnetic ratio, which is specific to particular nucleus. At 1.5 Tesla, the precessional frequency of hydrogen is 63.86 MHz. At 1 Tesla, the precessional frequency of hydrogen is 42.57 MHz. At 0.5 Tesla, the precessional frequency of hydrogen is 21.28 MHz. Basic 4 steps of MR imaging. First, placing the patient in the magnet. Second, sending radio frequency RF pulse by coil. Third, receiving signals from the patient by coil. Fourth, transformation of signals into image by complex processing in the computers. First, placing the patient in the magnet. All randomly moving protons in the patient body align and process along the external magnetic field. Longitudinally magnetization is formed along the z-axis. Second, sending RF pulse by coil. Precessing protons pick up energy from RF pulse to go to higher energy level and precess in phase with each other. This results in reduction in longitudinal magnetization and formation of transverse magnetization in XY plane. Third, MR signal is received. The transverse magnetization vector presses in transverse plane and generates current. This current is received as a signal by the RF coil. Fourth, image formation. MR signal received by the coil is transformed into image by complex mathematical process such as Fourier transformation by computers. Longitudinally magnetization. When patient is placed in the magnet, protons align parallel and anti-parallel to external magnetic field, that is, along positive and negative sides of z-axis. Forces of protons on negative and positive side cancel each other. However, there are always more protons spinning on the positive side or parallel to z-axis than negative side. So after cancelling each other forces, there are few protons on positive side that retain their forces. Forces of these protons add up together to form a magnetic vector along the z-axis. This is called as longitudinal magnetization. Transverse magnetization. After formed longitudinal magnetization, next step is to send radio frequency, RF pulse. The precessing protons pick up some energy from the radio frequency pulse. Some of these protons go to higher energy level and start precessing anti-parallel along negative side of the z-axis. The imbalance results in tilting of the magnetization into the transverse XY plane. This is called as transverse magnetization. In short, RF pulse causes tilting of the magnetization into transverse plane. MR signal. Transverse magnetization vector has a precession frequency. It constantly rotates at a Larmor frequency in the transverse plane and induces electric current while doing so. The receiver RF coil receives this current as MR signal. The strength of the signal is proportional to the magnitude of the transverse magnetization. MR signals are transformed into MR image by computers using mathematical methods such as Fourier transformation. Resonance in MRI. The precession frequency of protons should be same as RF pulse frequency for the exchange of energy to occur between protons and RF pulse. When RF pulse and protons have the same frequency, protons can pick up some energy from the RF pulse. This phenomena is called as resonance, the R of MRI.